Drew 2. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea, no shade. Hey, y'all, what's going on? We are on the air live talking about the Kanika Jenkins case and Christ, okay? We're going to talk about Kanika Jenkins, Jesus, and religion, and it has y'all all on blast, whatever that means. Because I know Christ is not destructive. See, when you learn to live by sound doctrine, you don't run around saying everything everybody else is saying. Like I'm on blast, especially if it's not your truth or biblical truth for that matter, as far as the scriptures are deemed to be true. I do believe that there is enough truth in the scriptures to set you free from the oppression of slavery and of it all. And I do believe that there is enough lies and contradictions in there to suppress you in your walk with Yahweh. You know him as God. And your spiritual upbringing. That's why I have been created for times such as these, to open your blind eyes and heal your deaf ears. I say a lot of stuff out of my heart, because out of the heart the abundance of the mouth speak. But you won't hear me talking phrases after the world. So what is blast? And why do people say it? Half the people probably don't even know what the word means. All I know is that I was led by the Holy Spirit y'all, to just bring you a message from Yahweh. Part of it is thus saith the Lord, and then the other part of it is just me speaking out of the Spirit which he has given me, which the Bible says if you obey the Lord, if you obey Yahweh God, the Most High God, because you say God and don't put a name to it, you're talking about any God, but his name is Yahweh. And he says that, you know, he gave me a spirit that'll bear witness in heaven with his spirit, giving me all truths concerning Christ. I don't know about Jesus, but I do know about Christ, and I do know about the Holy Spirit. So y'all, let me know if the name speaks for itself. Kanika Jenkins and religion, Jesus, Christ even, has y'all all on blast. When I got up this morning, which today is the 14th of January, this conversation took place on January 13th, to be very honest with you. I just didn't do the video yesterday because I was having slow technical difficulty with uploading other videos, and it just didn't go off yesterday. And it was placed in my heart, in my spirit, to follow up with the video I did the day before yesterday, which was would have been the 12th, called New Kanika Jenkins and Christ Outlook. R-I-H, or Lord have mercy on us all, pretty much, you decide. It pretty much states that Kanika and Christ cannot die two different ways, even though some of you still believe they are still alive. Please check out youtube.com/religionlink. It's a hashtag symbol, and it's religion winked with ED on the end of it, past tense, all one word. Subscribe, share, and like. Leave your comments below and let me know what you think. We can always have a discussion, because I love to talk everything up to Yahweh, because it exhorts, encourages, and comforts without leaving you high and dry and just out there hanging with a broke heart. No. We talk it up to God. You can sip all the tea you want, as it says in the beginning of the video, with no shade, okay? Because, you know, our community is hurting so bad right now. We are so impoverished with a lot of things, but it has to do with the conditions of our hearts. If you ever heard about a blight condition of a community, well, that's the condition of some people's heart. In Psalms 51:10, I believe, says, Lord, created me a new heart and renew my right spirit in me. And I think once our community, black people, get that down in their spirits, we can overcome the oppression, the hatred, the anger, the bitterness, the slavery that goes on in our communities and from other nations and tribes right now, because they see we do it to ourselves, so they take free shots at us all the time. So you guys go ahead and check out a couple of those videos over there, because I'm pretty much in all my videos debunking Christianity as a religion for the slaves and reminding people who act as Christians that you are the chosen people, the real children of Israel. And I have blood work to prove it. I don't know about you, but my blood work, when I get my blood work done, there's an enzyme missing, and it's called G6PD deficiency. It's a small enzyme. It can do quite damage on one side if you don't avoid certain things. But to be perfectly honest, it proves that this deficiency of enzyme does not run in the white Jews or white people, period. And it comes from, well, they'll label it the Kurdistan, Mizrahi, or the Sephardic Jews from the northern part of Africa. If you look at the 1400-1500 early maps, if you look at a map, if you can get it, where God split the Tower of Babel and pulled that down and the land split Saudi Arabia and Africa, you will know that Saudi Arabia, Africa, and Israel is just like really on the same continent. They all touch at the northern part of Africa. So, you know, I know, I know y'all like anywho, but I'm different. I like to say anyhey. Please accept the fact that I'm different, y'all. Thank you with all sincerity. Because at anywho, you have everybody saying it. And just like it with Christianity and speaking in tongues, you have everybody sounding alike with tongues, everybody wanting to be like everybody else. And I pray and ask God every day for my uniqueness, my peculiarness, as the Bible says, to stand out, you know. And to begin our talk up to Yahweh, sipping all the tea you want again with no shade, we will exhort, encourage, and comfort throughout this talk, affecting everyone involved. So like, share, subscribe. Let everybody hear this, guys. Because when I first came over on YouTube, my thing says, my information says July, but I probably started posting videos maybe October along in there somewhere. Maybe even later than that in last year. But it's like, when I first came on here, I started, you know, following, just not following like subscribing, but just following the Kanika Jenkins case, because it was the hottest thing trending, and everything was just like not a blur. Don't get me wrong, I'm not dumb or ignorant or anything like that, because the wisdom of Yahweh encamps about me, and you know, that's not being conceited. The Bible says we don't cast away your confidence, and you grow that when you know the true revelation. The Bible says the wisdom of revelation, you will come to the full knowledge and understanding of who Christ is through Yahweh God. This Jesus guy and this Christianity religion and everything else that's going on out here in the world about Christ, Jesus, and religion, y'all can have it, because the truth shall set you free, and I've been set free. Amen. So anyway, you know, let me just go ahead. All right, so shout out to Planet of the Fates. I love this terminology right now, being that I am an ex-Christian, born again, children of Israel, Hebrew, Israelite. I used to be a dipped in the blood of Jesus kind of Christian, where I was so dipped in his blood, I couldn't even feel the presence of God who created Jesus in his blood. And some of you Christians are still like that today, let me tell you. But me, let me tell my story. Let me live and tell my truth, and you tell your own. If you need help, I'll help you get yours out there, but you have to be willing to keep it real. Know who you are as a black person, as a white person, because it doesn't matter. I hope you get your story out. But we can't keep mixing Christianity up with our heritage, because that's not who we are. And slavery is not who we are. It's not your begin-all. It's not your end-all. You people just have to open up your eyes, open up your ears, and understand what thus saith the Lord. You have a spirit of sleep. A spirit of sleep, the Bible says. And I think it's in, ain't no thing, Romans 8 and 11. You have a spirit of sleep, a slumber, eyes that don't see, ears that don't hear, unto this day, because of your ignorance and disobedience and your willingness not to humble yourself. God says, follow no other God but me, but you're following Jesus and Christianity. So that's disobedience in and of itself. And that's why many of you who were sold into slavery, the Bible says the Americas and the islands of the sea, so that covers everything this side, you would say, west of Africa, over here, because we are the western ways, and everybody belong back over there in the east. But anyway, you are walking in Deuteronomy 28, verses 15 through 68, called the curse. And, you know, like I said, I'll help you get yours out there, but you have to be willing to keep it real, or as you folks say, 100, LOL, I'm laughing. I had wrote some of these notes down. But nonetheless, I studied mathematics before, and my name used to be called Queen Earth Asia when I was 18. And if you're so smart, and I don't like using that word smart again, you got to go back to like the first dictionary to understand. Shout out to Who Told You So, used to be 33 Midnight Cry or something like that. God bless you, because she's out here living her truth as a Hebrew Israelite. We're talking about the Hebrew people. You know, there's a book in the Bible called Hebrew. So we're talking about those Hebrew people. The Hebrew people and the Israelites in New York that's out there raping people, God have mercy on them. They are our people. And not all God people make God look good. You understand what I'm saying? But we are the real chosen people. And shout out to Who Told You So on YouTube. God bless you. We walk with the same kind of kindred spirit. Now, I wrote a book, and it will be out probably by the end of this month, called The Covenant, My Truth in Me. And I was able to find some very good quotes from Hitler himself, Mark Twain, and Winston Churchill about the real Jews. And one thing, paraphrasing what Hitler said, quoting him if I can remember right, saying the Jews that he like offended, you know, were bastards. He said they were not the real Jews. He went on to say that the real Jews, and because I'm not going to get into that, but he said is Near Asian, Oriental, and Negroid. He didn't say that kind of Egyptian and African Negroid, but the Hebrew people are Negroid people. And that's why they call us nigger, probably, because they know that we are of an African tribe in Israel. We're the Hebrew people that came out of Abraham, but we're not an African we are African people, don't get me wrong, but not your traditional African people. We are set apart. And that means the Jamaicans, the Haitians, everybody that's over here that's living in America and out in the seas, the waters, the Bible says. And there's some truth to that. Do your research. You can, there's prophecy where these people will be today from the Bible, and you can follow their culture. I have another book called In the Eyes of God, Black People Lives Matter Now and Then. Go get it, Amazon.com. We are so twisted out here, but there's some truth, thanks be to God. And I know people are afraid of the truth because Christ himself got killed for the truth. Bob Marley, I like to throw in there. Hail Selassie, I disappear. Marcus Garvey, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King. Now, I like to throw in these two lighter brothers right here, John F. K., because he was opening up some doors to black people. He might have still had his little resistance. But you got to remember, in politics, people can't talk Jesus Christ, God, as much as Martin Luther King would have wanted to. But, you know, you got to hold that back because people get afraid of getting killed for speaking the truth. But out of him, Reverend Jackson and Al Sharpton, he held them. He was the anointed one. And I sometimes think they might have conspired to get rid of him so that they can stand on his shoulders, as they say, and stand on each other's shoulders instead of the word of God, which Martin Luther King did stand on, because he said, "Let judgment rain down from heaven." You understand what I'm saying? But these guys right here, and Abe had an old mundane, miserable life. But old Abe claimed he, you know who really set the slaves free, don't you? Miss Harriet Tubman. She probably was getting rid of so many slaves underground, he ain't had no choice but to step up and abolish slavery. Because she was doing it way before he probably stepped up and did it publicly. Because she said, "I remember what Moses did to free my ancestors, those who was in slavery with Pharaoh, and somehow it got to her over here in America, and it was passed down into her tradition." But see, after Harriet Tubman, you people don't want to remember the truth. Y'all don't want to remember. You's like, "Oh no, yep, she said, I remember what Moses did." Moshe, actually, because that was his name. Remember, Kunta Kinte got turned to Toby, and y'all don't know who God's name is, your name is, or your kid's name, nobody name. Y'all just giving them these names, and it could mean devil, and you don't even know that. You better be right with yourself and your family and your kids. But nonetheless, let's move on. I studied mathematics before, and if you, again, I don't like the word smart, but if you so full of wisdom, which the Bible says that the wisdom of man is worse off than the foolishness of what God's wisdom, and God ain't got too much foolishness. Well, he might have created some foolish people, but we don't call people fools, the Bible said, and you in fire of hell. You are in judgment of hell fire and fire hell, it says. And that's in Matthew 5:22. So don't be going around here calling nobody a fool. But he created some foolish people. The Bible talks about foolish people, but it say don't call people a fool, okay? And you figuring out what mathematics is will 100 really mean, okay? And just like I said, for those that don't know, it's a black thing. It's a spiritual thing. It can tie back to our ancestry. But it's just the uniqueness and the difference to set ourselves apart, to kind of have our own religion and own way of building up our character and our conscience and our spirit man so that we can be free, okay? That's why Kanika Jenkins and Jesus and Religion have you all on blast for that specific reason, being uneducated to what's really going on in this world. Just like they did the people who followed the real Christ, now these people are following Jesus. The triplet twin brother of Zeus and the first pope. The entity of the pope, I will say it like that. Because they carry on that tradition, thinking it's Christ, but Jesus, but it's really not. Do your research. Because the people who follow Jesus are still lost, and it's in part due to blindness in Romans 11:8. I retracted it. It's 11:8. I had it backwards, okay? It says, according as it is written, God hath given them a spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears they should not hear unto this day. Can you really trust and believe them? This is the book of Romans this Bible is written to. But nonetheless, I have a problem with some of the Romans' concepts and theology based on religion given to the black American slaves who run around here making God look real bad right now over religion and Jesus and some Christ, because some people argue and fight over the real Christ, and no, if you just unite, you'll get more done. Where two or three are gathered, he in the midst, and where two or three mouth speaks, they establish a thing, okay? It don't take the whole social media network to do this, but if you want to see some change in your life, start learning your truth and understand what it is, okay? But, yeah, I have a problem believing what some of them Roman people over there say, okay? And that's my prerogative. It sets me free knowing the truth about their culture, because when you know the truth about somebody else's culture, it shines light on your culture. Some people got some dark past, and they want your past to be dark like theirs, and they want you to continue to live in darkness. That's why they don't want you to know the truth. And they keep sending you to Bible college Christians for you to be further indoctrinated and dipped in the blood of Jesus, and you'll never know your truth. Okay? Because I tell you again, you people like to serve the creation, what God created in those 6 days. On the seventh day he rests. That's why Saturday is your Sabbath, thus saith the Lord. And you should keep it holy, okay? But that's why a lot of you people eat pork, which is against your dietary custom law, your dietary laws and customs. These things that the Grecian Roman Empire did to the people who followed the real Christ is still being done to the people who follow Jesus today. That's why they call Yah the lost sheep of Israel. Oh, Lord, come on and know who you are. Do your research. They ain't calling the white people, those Jews over there in Israel, the lost sheep. Everybody came out of Noah, and take it for what it is. People, the human race, I say lighter brother, darker brother, just like our ancestors did in slavery. Read some of Langston Hughes' poems. If you don't educate yourself, you will never grow. You will never grow. Educate yourself. It's free. Pain isn't. Pain isn't. And a lot of y'all is out there suffering and hurting and pain, and you don't even know why. If I was mad and angry and upset and didn't know what was, I want to hold up. I'm checking out. I got to find out what's making me angry. I got to find out what's making me mad. I got to find out what's making me not hate people. I got to find out why I'm on blast over Kanika Jenkins when a lot of whole other people done died in this world and need much more attention than that, like Christ, who can save your soul. Dig into his past. Dig into his life. Dig into his journey and his ministry, and you will be set free. Kanika Jenkins only driving you further into your grave, further into hatred, driving your communities apart, driving your families apart, driving your whole entire world apart. Why? Over some little coins and videos on YouTube? When there's other things that you can put your mind to that you don't have to manipulate, that you can go out and make your own stuff and create your own stuff. We are the most, Winston Hughes said, we are the most formidable people that ever appeared in the face of the earth. Do your research. Yes. Know who you're dealing with. God is an awesome God, because let me tell you why. He took a man named Abraham who lived in the land of Ur, Chaldees, put him in another land, and made some Hebrew Jewish people come out of him. Now, we all ain't Jewish people. There was only one son named Levi. Named Judah, excuse me. Levi was the high priest. I was trying to see. It was Reuben, Simeon, Levi. Judah may have been the fourth son with Leah and Jacob, because Jacob did not have all his kids by Rachel. He only had Benjamin and Joseph by Rachel, okay? And not all the real tribe, 12 brothers, became the 12 tribes of Israel. You got to understand that too. Two of the brothers, I know Dan is one of them, He was kicked out, and when on his deathbed, Jacob adopted two of Joseph's sons, Ephraim and Manasseh. And Ephraim and Manasseh became the two tribes that he didn't give two of his, Jacob didn't give two of his sons a blessing, okay? So his grandsons, Joseph's sons, came in and make up the 12 tribes. Read your Bible, 12 tribes of Israel. Matter of fact, Dan became the brother Dan. I don't know what birthplace he is. I have it written down somewhere. But Dan is like, he became the Sanhedrins, the Pharisees, and the scribes that Jesus had to face off with, because Dan got rebellious. You know, when the Hebrew men was giving out their blessings, Dan wanted to be the high priest. But the Levites, the Haitians, got to be the high priest. Do your research, people. So anyway, for me to say I trust and believe in those Roman Catholic people, I want to have a meeting with the Pope, and we need to sit down and do what 2 Timothy 2:15 says, if he does this. And then sit down and says, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman need not to be ashamed out here in front of nobody, rightly dividing the word of truth. And until the Roman people can sit down and rightly divide the word of truth with somebody who understands the word of truth, their history, my history, their relationship with Christ and Jesus, because they got a relationship with Jesus. I told you, he's the twin brother of Zeus. But with Yeshua, the messenger of Yahweh and Yahweh himself, we can sit down and rightly divide this word, because they got a lot of questions to answer according to the book of Romans chapter 1. Read it. Read it. You have to read it. Come on now. See, and another thing that got, like I said earlier, to have you out here kicking the pricks, like Jesus told, like Christ told Paul, Paul, you know how, see, Paul had his name changed in the Bible too. So the European white man said, since Christ changed Paul's name, we gonna get him over here in America, and we gonna change their name. But this book of Psalms 83 prophesies and foretells that these people conspired against you to make you forget who you were as a nation, Israel. Not who the Jewish Ashkenazi Jews are, according to Genesis 10. They got their forefather name is Japheth. One of the sons, Noah only had three. He may be the baby son. He the third son, I say, because that's how they name him in the Bible, is Japheth. And Japheth was no J's then in that language, in that culture, in that time. But Japheth went to the isles, listen people, of the Gentiles. So you are not the Gentiles, because Japheth took him and his Caucasian family, families that went into the mountains of the Caucasus Mountain, family who had less melanin in them and no melanin in them, and they just went on that way. They went on about their business. And he had a grandson named Ashkenazi. And Ashkenazi is the tribe those people come out of that lives in Israel today. But I'm going to tell you something about Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68 says, it prophesies and foretells slavery, and that in of itself will cause people today to be just like our ancestors. Now, in part, and so, these people, according to Psalms 83, sold you into slavery. And the Bible says that nobody will buy you. Nobody will buy you in verse 68. But the very first chapter says, Moshe, tell them, hearken unto my voice this day. They'll have the blessing. Hearken unto my voice this day. I'm tired of y'all stiff-necked, rebellious people from the wilderness days of wandering, from being freed from slavery from Pharaoh. 40 years in the wilderness. Joshua ain't take y'all over in the Jordan yet, because we still in the book of Deuteronomy. But a lot of stuff goes on from the wilderness days in Exodus, when Bob Marley sings about Exodus. We exited out of Egypt, but we ain't belong in Egypt. Hello? Do you get that, people? And he sung about the Exodus, Bob Marley did. And during this Exodus, you were rebellious, you was hard-hearted, you was stiff-necked. Down to this day, you Christian believers dipped in the blood of Jesus, followers are hard-headed, hard-hearted, and stiff-necked and rebellious. And you don't, he called you stiff-necked because you don't want to repent and turn to God. You want to follow every other God out here but the one true God. And Jesus is not your God. I don't know how many times I have to express it like this, but Jesus is not your God. And if Jesus was created by God, he's a creation, not the creator. So you have to turn your stiff neck and your hard hearts and your rebellious attitudes back to Yahweh. If you look in your Bible,